Hi everyone, trust you all are doing well. So this was a poll that we created for you guys a couple of weeks ago. So as you can see, 11 days ago, so I made a comment. So this, it will end today. So I wanted to give you guys a chance to all vote. So I just want to say thank you to the awesome 68 viewers that voted. We really appreciate you and we love you all. Right, so they voted. And we wanted to check if we need to do a lot of our LiveWire chat app with Pusher, or we need to do a Laravel LiveWire app without Pusher, or we're just going to create a RESTful Laravel API. But some of you actually requested something very interesting. On top of that, if we can maybe just create a simple project, okay, or we need to do it with Laravel and Next.js or React Native. JS Dope also asked if we can maybe do one with Next.js and all that kind of stuff. So it's kind of very interesting. So in the comment section right there. So this is obviously the clear winner, but I got a little surprise for you. Since we have our clear winner of the RESTful API, I thought, why don't we do something like this? So we're going to still do the backend with the Laravel for to create the API, but with the front end, ta-da! So what we're going to do is we're going to do one on the front end with Next.js. Then we're going to do one with Nuxt.js and one with Svelte. All right. And any other suggestions, welcome. So if you guys want to suggest anything else, please leave it for us in the comments section. So I can already hear the comments. Next.js is like a framework for a framework. So in this case, it's a framework for React. And Nuxt.js is like a framework for another framework, which is, in this case, Vue.js. So I'm going to do one for Next.js, one for Nuxt, and one for Svelte. Svelte is actually a very nice JavaScript framework. Very, very, very nice. So if you guys want to have any other suggestions just with React itself or just with plain Vue, you guys can let me know in the comment section. So that's what we're going to do. I'm hoping to do this whole project, to be honest with you, in Laravel 9. Hope then we can, I actually can show you all the new stuff as well. So while we're building it, so we can learn that as well. Now, the packages that we're going to use is we're going to use Laravel Sanctum for authentication and generate tokens. And we're going to use Laravel Breeze for the API, kind of the scaffolding right there for the login and register and all that kind of stuff, and plus more. Now, the other thing what we're going to do is we're going to do for API testing. We can either use Postman, or we can use Insomnia, or we can use Thunder Client, which is a VS Code extension. So if you guys want to know how that looks like, so this is kind of how it looks like. It almost, for me personally, it's almost something like Postman. Or we can learn how to actually write some tests, so to, or actually to check if everything works well. But since I haven't created a course on writing tests yet, I don't know if I need to add that. So this might be optional. And we're going to go through all of these when I start creating the course, when I do an introduction to the course. We're still going to get there. But I just want to kind of give you guys a taster of what we're going to be dealing with when we create this. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create the Laravel API. Then after that, we're going to do it with one of the front end frameworks. But we're going to do all of these. So this is the one that's guaranteed that we're going to do. We're going to guarantee use one for Next. Then we're going to create another one with Nuxt.js with the same Laravel API that we're going to create, and another one with Svelte with the same API that we create. So we're going to create all these three for so long. So if you guys want to add more, please add them for me in the comment section. Now, then I'm obviously going to decide which one, and it depends on if the users are interested or not, right? Because there's some that only want this channel to remain tall stack, but for my own growth purposes and all that, I cannot stick to that because there's not a big enough audience for that. But I want to keep you guys happy, so the channel will remain Laravel focused, but we're going to add here and there some extra JavaScript stuff. All right, because this is quite very, very useful to learn, and later on we can maybe add some machine learning or AI things as well going forward. That's all due for later. But anyways, I just wanted to leave that to you guys. So just wanted to make the results quite known so that you guys know what to expect. Please leave it for me in the comment section. And we're going to be I'm not going to release any videos for the next 2 weeks. So I'm only going to do it in January. So thank you guys. And please stay off the computers. Take a little break from the computer. Spend some time with the family if it's possible. And yes, I'll see you guys in January with this course for the Laravel API. Thank you guys for watching. Like the video if you like it. And please leave it for me a comment. Thank you and adios.